Certainly, Christmas is a time of giving and sharing those around us. But that sharing is not limited to those that we love and care for. It's also for the person that we have never met and will never see. Those that are not as fortunate as we are in their lives. I'm reminded of a story about a shoemaker who lives with his wife in a small house. He is very poor, doesn't have any money left with him. He has only some leather left to make a pair of shoes. One evening, he cut the leather for a pair of shoes. He thought he would make in the morning and prayed to God for a good day and goes to sleep. The next morning, the shoemaker finds a beautiful pair of shoes on his table in the shop and sells it for a hefty price. For many days, this continues and the shoemaker turns rich by selling the shoes made by the elves. The shoemaker and his wife are very pleased. They decide to find out who their helpers are and express their gratitude towards them. They make clothes for the elves in order to thank them for their service. The two little elves come at midnight and are happy to see the clothes. They wear it, go only, never return. The shoemaker lives a happy and prosperous life thereafter, and the little elves are pleased too. It's a remarkable story to teach the importance of sharing and hard work. Sharing always reaps its reward. The true meaning of Christmas is sharing ourselves with others. It means giving to others who need our help, reviving the old traditions that we have formed over the years and remembering our past. It's a time of love and generosity. It's a spirit of giving without a thought of getting. It's happiness because we see joy in the people. It's forgetting self and finding time for others. It's discarding the meaningless and stressing the true values. Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta said, "Give until it hurts." In the Gospel of Saint John, chapter 3, verse 16 says, "God so loved the world that he sent his only son." In the book of Genesis, chapter 12, we see God asked Abraham, the father of faith, to sacrifice his only son. This is God the Father's love for each of us. Dear friends, let us not think that when I have plenty or when all my needs are fulfilled, I start sharing. During this time of pandemic, let us give a new meaning to our celebration of Christmas by sharing what we have and what we are with those needy persons around us.